about trigonometric identities. There are a number of trigonometric identities, but we discuss some of these identities here, mainly three identities and the related results. And before entering to the details, we need some notation we usually use here, which is the exponential expression of trigonometric functions, power of trigonometric functions. So consider the trigonometric function or trigonometric ratio, say sine x, sine y, or sine a, sine b. So we can have the multiple of this, that is sine x into sine x, which is actually this sine x whole squared. This expression, this representation is actually an elaborated expression, that is putting brackets and then squaring. So this is inconvenient, and therefore what we do is we remove this bracket and write. And if we write this in the form sine x squared, then there may arise a confusion whether this is sine x squared or sine x squared. There may arise some confusion. If we want to find the sine of this x squared, then again that also will be written in this form. Therefore, this sine x whole squared cannot be written in this fashion. So what we do is, we write this exponent here, sine squared, then x. This power 2 is written adjacent to the sine as an exponent, superscript, and write in this way. So this means sine x cos squared. Similarly, this cos squared x, tan squared x, and all others. Higher powers can also be written like this, sine cube x, which means sine x whole cube, cos cube x, which means cos x whole cube. So in that way, in that fashion, we write the powers of this trigonometric ratios or the exponents of this exponential expression of this trigonometric functions or trigonometric ratios. Okay, and now we can come to the details of this trigonometric identities. And now the three trigonometric identities. So consider the rectangular triangle ABC, right angled at B. Then for this right angled triangle, we have the Pythagoras theorem, which is hypotenuse square is equal to base squared plus altitude squared. That is, this BC squared plus AB squared is equal to AC squared. This BC squared plus AC squared is equal to AB squared is equal to AC squared. This base squared plus altitude squared is equal to hypotenuse squared. And then in this expression we have three quantities. One, this BC squared means BC whole squared. And this AB squared and AC squared. We have these three expressions. Then the three identities are obtained when we divide this relation, this BC squared plus AB squared is equal to AC squared, throughout with respect to these three expressions. Dividing throughout this expression with the AC squared, we will get one identity. Dividing this throughout with respect to this AB squared, we get another identity. And dividing this throughout with this BC squared, we will get the third identity. And from this each identity, we can derive two more related results also. So this is the way in which we find the three identities. First, we will discuss the first identity in this video, and the remaining two identities will be discussed in the next video. So to get the first identity and the related result, first we divide throughout this expression with this AC squared. So dividing with the AC squared, we get BC squared by AC squared plus AB squared by this AC squared is equal to AC squared by AC squared. AC squared by AC squared. And now consider this BC squared by AC squared. BC squared by AC squared is equal to this BC by AC all squared plus AB by AC all squared, which is equal to 1. ABC squared by AC squared is equal to 1. And now consider this BC by AC. BC by AC, opposite side by hypotenuse, which is sine squared A plus AB squared by AC squared, AB squared by AC squared, adjacent side by hypotenuse all squared, which is cos squared A is equal to 1. So this is the identity, the first identity. Sine squared A plus sine cos squared A is equal to 1 for any angle A. If the angle is B, sine squared B plus cos squared B is equal to 1. If the angle is X, sine squared X plus cos squared X is equal to 1. So this is the first identity. And then from this we can have two more identities, related identities, related results. First one is this sine squared A is equal to 1 minus cos squared A, transposing this cos squared A to the right side. Simple one. Very simple. And the second is this cos squared A is equal to 1 minus sine squared A. That's right. So the identity is sine squared A plus cos squared A is equal to 1. And the related identities or related results are sine squared A is equal to 1 minus cos squared A, and cos squared A is equal to 1 minus sine squared A. So these are the results. Okay? The remaining two identities will be in the next video.